last session, we have discussed about digestion of carbohydrate in human body. Here we will discuss about digestion of protein in human body. Okay. So first, before we understand the process of digestion, we have to understand what are the forms of protein present in our body. Which are the forms of protein our body needs to work on and present in our food sources. Okay, so sources, or you can consider it as forms of protein also. The major two proteins present in our body, or rather present in all the food sources which is being digested in our body, is albumin and globulin. Except that, nucleoproteins, mucin, collagen, elastin. These are the types of protein which are present in most of the dietary sources, and whether they are that is a veg dietary source or non-veg dietary source, these are the mostly present protein or most common proteins found in food particles. Okay, and in our body, majorly these proteins are digested under the influence of different enzymes. And the next category is, or the next portion we will understand along with this, is the categories of protein found in our body. We get protein from three type of sources: either proteins from diet, protein from digestive juices. Why proteins from digestive juices? We all know. We all know that our digestive juices contains certain enzymes, and all enzymes are proteins by nature. And what we have learned when we were studying about the characteristics of enzymes, that protein has a certain characteristic of getting degraded after a certain time. Every protein structure is degraded after a certain time. So the enzymes which are working at this moment, after a certain time, they will be destroyed or damaged. They will be degenerated. When they will be degenerated, it will produce new fragments of proteins. Again, that will be used by your body. So when at that time, enzymes which are active at that moment will work on those fragment proteins. So protein from diet, proteins from digestive juices. Another category, proteins from degenerated cells. Proteins from degenerated cells. We all know our body conducts a constant process of damage and repair, damage and repair. That means cells which has been exhausted after working for a long time, performing all the functions, they are destroyed, and they are replaced by new cells. But when a cell is destroyed, the major cellular material, which is protein, again is used by your body. So again, your enzymes which are active at that moment will work on the protein fragments obtained from degeneration of cell. So these are the basic categories of protein which your body obtains and reutilizes through the process of digestion. Now we will enter in the detailing of the process of digestion, but before we understand the process of digestion, we need to understand two categories of enzymes which work on proteins. Now I will discuss about categories of enzymes. exopeptide is and endopeptide is. It will be better if you write the order in auxa propositor manner. Endo should be first mentioned and then you should mention exopeptide is. Endopeptides are the proteolytic enzymes secreted from upper part of alimentary canal or tract. I can use pepsin as an example. Pepsin is secreted from stomach, so obviously upper part of our alimentary canal. So endopeptides are proteolytic enzymes secreted from upper part of alimentary tract, example pepsin. Exopeptides are proteolytic enzymes secreted from lower part of alimentary canal, example carboxypeptides. Now what these enzymes are, how they work, we will come to the discussion when we will discuss about the process of digestion step by step. But this is an overview of the categories of enzymes involved in the entire process of protein digestion. So this basic things, that what are the proteins present in different sources of diet, and proteins which are digested under the influence of different enzymes in our body. The next point you have to write or you have to mention is sources, categories of sources of protein. That is one from digestive juice, one from cell degeneration, and from diet. See, next one, enzymes. There are two categories, exopeptides and endopeptides. Then you will come to the final discussion where you will discuss about the digestion of protein in different parts of our body. I will start with mouth. Well, mouth secretes saliva, we all know. Rather, salivary gland secretes saliva, which gets mixed with the food in mouth after the teeth breaks them in smaller pieces, and the saliva, the tongue and teeth work in a combination to mix the saliva with the smaller pieces or the paste, which is called bolus. So, salivary juice does not contain any proteolytic enzyme. So basically no digestion of protein occurred in mouth. Only saliva moist the food particles, bolus is formed, which will enter to the stomach. But no digestion of protein occurs in saliva. But you have to write that you cannot skip the location of mouth. You have to write in mouth, then you have to write no proteolytic enzyme is there, that is why no digestion occurs, but only food is broken down to smaller pieces and it is converted into a paste like structure, which is called bolus. After mouth, the next location we will consider is stomach. Stomach is actually one of the In stomach, we all know gastric gland secretes gastric juice, which has HCl, which works on digestive carbohydrate, we have learned in the last session. But stomach also has another type of cell, which is known as peptic cell. Peptic cell secretes proteolytic enzyme pepsin, which work on protein. But the problem is, in our body most of the proteolytic enzymes are secreted in a inactivated form. Why? Because our entire body is formed with cells are formed with protein. If always the proteolytic enzymes will be in an activated state, they will keep destroying the cells of our structure. That is obviously we don't want. We want the food to be digested. We want the protein fragments to be digested, not our cells. So if always the enzymes will be in an activated state, they will keep destroying, or they will keep digesting the its own structures or cells. That is why most proteolytic enzymes are always secreted in inactivated form or zymogen. When we studied about characteristics of enzymes, we have came across the term zymogen or proenzyme, means the prior or inactivated form of enzyme. So proteopeptic cells secrete pepsin, but not in the form of active cell, pepsin. They secrete it in a form of pepsinogen, which is the zymogen of pepsin. Is the zymogen of pepsin. Okay, so pepsinogen, it is secreted. And now when the stomach receives protein source, then this pepsinogen will be converted to active pepsin. How? Pepsinogen will be converted to active pepsin by the action of HCl. The high acidic content is caused by HCl in stomach. That HCl activates pepsinogen and converts it to pepsin. This is active enzyme which now can act on protein. After the conversion of a certain amount of pepsinogen into pepsin, this active pepsin also act as a autocatalyst. That means its own active molecule can control the digestion of protein. Okay. The next thing you need to know is how pepsin acts and its characteristic. So this is how pepsin acts. Pepsin works on protein, converts it to acid metaprotein, then to primary protease, then to secondary protease, and then peptone. Pepsin cannot break the protein further after it is being converted to peptone. After the further digestion is dependent on the further enzymes. So pepsin can do till here only. Okay. So when you are writing the process of digestion under the influence of any type of enzyme, what I have said, you have to mention its properties. So these are the properties of pepsin. Pepsin works in a pH of 2.0, which is highly acidic. Because it works under the influence of HCl, it gets destroyed in alkaline medium, inactivated in alkaline medium. It works in a temperature around 40 degrees Celsius. A far lower temperature or far higher temperature both can destroy the structure of pepsin. Acha. And it can break the protein till peptone only. Another point we have to remember that that pepsin has a property of killing protein, or rather digesting protein. So obviously pepsin can digest the cells of stomach also. Stomach needs a protection. If pepsin can work very well into a pH of around 2, then obviously in stomach, as HCl is there, the pH is perfectly preferable for action of pepsin. Then pepsin will digest the cells of stomach also. Then it needs a protection. The cells of stomach, that means gastric cells, rather gastric mucosa, secretes anti-pepsin factor or has anti-pepsin factors which prohibits pepsin from digesting the cells of stomach. This is the auto-protective technique that our organ has. Okay, the rest of the process of digestion I will discuss in the next session. Thank you.